Hello, my dear students. How are you all? I hope you all are fit and fine. In our last class, we learned tenses. Okay, so today's topic is message writing. Today we will learn how to write a message. Okay, so let's get started. Message is a verbal, written or recorded communication sent to or left for a recipient who cannot be contacted directly. Okay, means suppose you are going out of your house, okay, and you have to inform this to your mother that where you are going and by what time you will be returning, but unfortunately your mother is not at home. Okay, so what will you do? Either you will say it to your father to convey the message to your mother, or you will write it somewhere so that your mother can see it, okay, and get the information. All right, that's why we write a message when we cannot contact the person directly to whom we are trying to convey the message. Now it can be in written form, verbal, like if you tell this to your father or anybody to convey it to your mother, or in the recorded form also. You can use your phone, okay, to record it for your mother to hear. All right, it is a means of communication containing some information, news, advice or the like sent by the messenger on telephone, email or other means. And it can be some information, news, advice or anything which is sent by the messenger who is giving the message to the recipient, okay, who will be receiving the message. It can be given on telephone or it can be mailed or any other means can be used for this. Okay, now we will see the format to write a message. Okay, first of all, you have to remember, to write a message you should draw a box, because a message should be written inside the box. All right, so you see a box is drawn here. And at the top, in the middle of the box, we have written message, okay, in capital letter, M-E-S-S-A-G-E, message should be written in capital letter. Then you will leave one, and in the next line, you will write date, okay, today's date, and date must be written in expanded form. Expanded form means, suppose today is 16th. Okay, or 17th. So we will write 17th December, 2020. Okay, it must be written in expanded form. Always when you will write this writings, no, like it can be any piece of writing like letter or message, expanded form of the date must be written. Okay, next is time. Time will be now, means when you are writing the message, at what time you are writing, you will include that time. Okay, then you will leave one line, then you will write salutation. Salutation is the receiver's name. Like as I have given you the example of, like suppose you are writing this message for your mother, so you will write your mother's name there. Mother's name means you can write dear mother or you can write simply mother. All right, next line, you will write the body of the message, the content, what you are going to write. Okay, what information you want to give to your mother. Okay, that will be the body of the message. And after writing everything, whatever you want to convey, all right, at last you will write sender's name. Sender's name means who is trying to convey the message. Okay, who is trying to convey the message? Here you are trying to convey the message to your mother, so your name must be written. Okay. Okay, see here, a sample is given. You are Ramesh. Today you had the following conversation with Rajesh, a friend of your elder brother. So suppose you think yourself as Ramesh and you had a conversation with Rajesh, who is your elder brother's friend. Okay, like a telephonic conversation. Rajesh is talking now. Hello, can I speak to Manish? Okay, Rajesh is saying, and you are Ramesh. So you answered, hello, I am Ramesh speaking, his brother. He is not at home. What can I do for you? Means here you are talking on behalf of your brother. Okay, you said that your brother is not at home. Now you are asking, what can I do for you? What can you do for him? Rajesh answered, well, Ramesh, I am Rajesh, you know, your brother's friend. Could you please convey him that he should bring my practical book tomorrow in school as I need it in class? Now Rajesh is trying to convey the message to Ramesh's elder brother that Rajesh needs his practical book tomorrow in school, and he is asking Ramesh's elder brother to bring the book in school. Okay, now Ramesh means you are answering, that's fine, I will do that. Means you said that you will convey this particular message to your elder brother, Manish. Okay, now as you are leaving for your school, write a message for your brother in about 50 words, put your message in a box. Now you are also going to leave for your school and Manish is not around. Okay. So what you will have to do, you will have to write the message somewhere for your brother to easily see it. Okay, that's why you will write the message. Now we will see how it is to be written. Now we will follow the proper format to write the message. Okay, to give the necessary details. First, I told you box must be drawn, and then at the top in the middle, you will write message in capital letter. Okay, next line you will write today's date, that is 5th April 2020. Okay, here for example, this is a sample message, so it is written the date like this, and then 5 p.m. Next line you will write the time, 5 p.m. is written. Okay, then you will leave one line, then you will write to whom you are going to write this message. You are going to write this message for Manish, your elder brother. Okay, so you have written your elder brother's name, Manish. Next line, I will read out the content, okay, the body of the message. Your friend Rajesh called up when you were not here. He requested to convey you to bring his practical book to school tomorrow as he needs it in class. I am going to play with my friends. Now see here, you have given the proper message what Rajesh told you to give. Rajesh told that Manish must bring Rajesh's practical book to school tomorrow as he will be needing it in school. So you have told what was being told to you. Okay, you have conveyed the message. As you are going to play with friends, so you cannot say it verbally, that's why you are writing it down. All right, and at last you will give your signature, means your name, leaving one line, Ramesh. So your brother will understand. I hope you have understood how to write a message. Just see the conversation, read the conversation properly, and then understand what is the message which is needed to be conveyed. Then write accordingly. That's it. Thank you.